हाई फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल IIBS IAS Academy. दिस इज राकेश सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट IIBS IAS Academy. आई हैव डन माई PGD BRM फ्रॉम मणिपाल यूनिवर्सिटी. सिंस लास्ट 6 ईयर्स आई हैव बीन टीचिंग टू द UPSC aspirant. In this YouTube channel, we will be discussing about the daily current affairs and the topics which are related to UPSC as well as the other competitive exams. Please do subscribe, like and comment on the below section. Good morning friends, welcome to IIBS IAS Academy. In today's class, we are going to discuss about one of the current affairs which is recently in news, that is Gupkar Declaration. So what is Gupkar Declaration, which is currently it is in news? So what is Gupkar Declaration? Okay, Gupkar Declaration, it is an declaration of a regional political party in the previous state of Jammu and Kashmir. So in Jammu, at present the Jammu and Kashmir has been bifurcated and it's become two union territory. One is Jammu and Kashmir and another is Ladakh. But previously, before August 2019, Jammu and Kashmir was single state and Jammu and Kashmir was having a special status under Article 370. Under Article 370, Jammu and Kashmir was having special status. So according to that special status, Jammu and Kashmir state used to have a separate constitution. Apart from that separate constitution, separate flag. Apart from that separate flag, there are certain provisions, okay, which make special status to the Jammu and Kashmir, like the law which is was made by the parliament, that was not applicable to the Jammu and Kashmir until unless Jammu and Kashmir Assembly accepted it. Okay. And apart from that, fundamental rights of the Indian Constitution, DPSP, Directive Principle of State Policies, or some other provisions of the Indian Constitutions were not applicable to the Jammu and Kashmir previously. But last year, in the month of August 2019, our present Home Minister Amit Shah has introduced that bill, that is Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Bill, and that bill become Act once that bill was passed by both the houses of the Parliament. So according to that Act, Reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir Act, Jammu and Kashmir lost its special status category. And apart from that, the territory of Jammu and Kashmir has divided into two union territory. One is Jammu and Kashmir and another is Ladakh. So Gupkar declaration. So Gupkar declaration, it is a declaration made by the six regional political party led by Omar Abdullah. Omar Abdullah belongs to National Conference Party. Okay. So under that Gupkar declaration, they want the restoration of the Article 370 as well as the special status of Jammu and Kashmir. So in short, the Gupkar declaration demand is that restoration of Article 370 as well as the special status of Jammu and Kashmir, which was present in Jammu and Kashmir before August 2019. So for us, important thing is that at present we should know what is the current status of Jammu and Kashmir. So the current status of Jammu and Kashmir, it is according to Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019. So the current situation of Jammu and Kashmir as well as the Ladakh, we can get to know under Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019. So according to the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019, as I said earlier, there was a bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir. That means Jammu and Kashmir state has divided into two union territory. One is Ladakh and another it is Jammu and Kashmir. So what are the previous things which were ceased to be operate or which were deleted or which were abrogated by the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019. Earlier, there was a separate constitution of Jammu and Kashmir. So at present, Jammu and Kashmir does not have any separate constitution. Apart from that, for law, there was a code, Ranbir Penal Code. So when we talk about the law, we talk about IPC, Indian Penal Code. So previously in Jammu and Kashmir, this code was followed, that is Ranbir Penal Code. So that Ranbir Penal Code was also ceased to be operate. At present, Jammu and Kashmir does not have any constitution, and the Jammu and Kashmir does not follow the Ranbir Penal Code. Then apart from that, the whole territory of Jammu and Kashmir has divided into two union territory. One is called Ladakh. Ladakh comprises Kargil and Leh district. Ladakh comprises Kargil as well as the Leh district. Okay, then apart from that, Jammu and Kashmir, another UT has been formed. So Jammu and Kashmir territories are those territories of the Jammu and Kashmir previous states except Kargil and Leh. So like this we can see. So regarding the territory of the two new union territory, Ladakh comprises two districts, that is Leh and Kargil. And regarding the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir, except the Leh and Kargil districts, all districts comprises the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. And the Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory also present that area which were occupied by the Pakistan, or popularly it is called POK or Pakistan Occupied Kashmir. And the Union Territory of Ladakh does not have assembly. The Union Territory of Ladakh does not have assembly. The Union Territory of Ladakh will be administrated by Lieutenant Governor. The Union Territory of Ladakh will be administrated by Lieutenant Governor. The Lieutenant Governor will be appointed by the President of India. The Lieutenant Governor will not elect. The Lieutenant Governor will be appointed by President of India. We'll talk about the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. So Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, it is having assembly. The Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir is having assembly, while Ladakh does not have assembly. Then we must know about the Jammu and Kashmir assembly. Okay, so it is the lieutenant governor will act as the administrator of the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. And who will appoint this Lieutenant Governor? It is the President of India who will appoint the Lieutenant Governor, and the tenure will also determined by the President of India. That Lieutenant Governor tenure will also determined by President of India. Apart from that, the Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory has been allotted 4 Rajya Sabha seat and 5 Lok Sabha seat. The Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir is at present, it is having 4 Rajya Sabha seat and 5 Lok Sabha seat. And apart from that, there are total 10 assembly seat in Jammu and Kashmir assembly. Total 107 seat in the Jammu and Kashmir assembly that has to be filled through direct election. Apart from 107, 24 seats will be vacant. So out of 107 seat, 24 seats will be vacant. Why this seat will be vacant? Why? Because these seats were belongs to the POK area, Pakistan Occupied Kashmir. So that Pakistan Occupied Kashmir is not administrated by the central government of India, or it is not administrated by the Indian government. So there is no possibility of conducting the election in those 24 seats which were allotted in the Pakistan Occupied Kashmir. So in short, at present, Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory has total 107 assembly seat, and election has to be held, okay, except 24 seats in Jammu and Kashmir assembly. Then apart from that, there is a reservation. So in the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir, there is also a reservation for SC as well as the ST. So reservation is based upon the proportion of population in the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. So that is the basis for reservation in union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. And apart from that, there is also reservation for women in the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. It was Lieutenant Governor. Lieutenant Governor has a power to nominate two women in the Assembly of Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. If Lieutenant Governor think that if woman is not appropriate or proportionally represented in the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir, at that time Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir will nominate two women in the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. But remember, it is not compulsory for the Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir to nominate two women in the Assembly each and every time. There is no compulsory. If no representative woman in the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir, at that time only Lieutenant Governor can nominate two women in the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. Then we'll talk about the tenure. The tenure of the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir is 5 years. The tenure of the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir is 5 years. So when we talk about the power of the Assembly, at present the subjects in India has been divided into three lists, that is Union List, State List and Concurrent List. Union List, State List and Concurrent List. So the power of the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir is that it has the power to make a law in any subject which are mentioned in State List as well as the Concurrent List, but except two subject, that is law and order and police. So these are the two subject on which the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir cannot make law. Then who made law on these two subject? It is central government. Central government has exclusive power to make a law on subject like law and order and police in case of union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Same in Delhi also, same thing. So same it is as Delhi and same for union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. So that is about the power of Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. And apart from that, previously means before August 2019 or before the bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir state. So the Jammu and Kashmir state was having bicameralism. Then what is the meaning of bicameralism? Bicameralism is nothing but having two houses in legislature. Take an example. In parliament we have two houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. In the same way, at state level also, many Indian states, not all, many Indian states, they are having the bicameralism. They are having the assembly, they are having the council also. They are having MLA and as well as they are having MLC, member of legislature council. So before bifurcation, the state of Jammu and Kashmir was having bicameralism. That means the state of Jammu and Kashmir was having MLA or member of legislature assembly as well as the MLC, the member of legislature council. But after the bifurcation and according to the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019, now the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir is unicameralism, means only single house, that is assembly. So at present the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir does not have the council, but the bills which were pending in the council before the bifurcation, so all those bills has been lapsed, or the all those bills has been ceased to be operated. So at present there is no bicameralism in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Apart from that, Jammu and Kashmir is having chief minister also. Chief minister. Then who will appoint the chief minister? Chief minister will be appointed by the lieutenant governor. Apart from that, the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir will have council of ministers also. Take an example of Delhi. In Delhi, we have chief minister as well as the other council of minister. In the same way, in the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir, it is having chief minister as well as the other ministers. So it is the lieutenant governor who will appoint the chief minister to the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir, and it is the lieutenant governor who will appoint the other ministers in the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir on the recommendation of chief minister. Then the council of minister or the other minister, council of minister including the chief minister of the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir should not be consist more than 10% of total number of seat in Jammu and Kashmir assembly. That means, take an example, at present Jammu and Kashmir is having total number of seat, that is 107. So the 10% of 107 is approximately 11. Okay, 11%. So the chief minister including the other council of minister should not be more than 11. So that is the provision under Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019. Then what are the powers of lieutenant governor? What lieutenant governor of union territory of Jammu and Kashmir can do or what it can't do? So as I mentioned earlier, in the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir, if women are not represented advocately, so at that time the lieutenant governor has a power to nominate two women in the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. So this is one of the power of lieutenant governor. Then apart from that, the ministers, the chief minister as well as the council of minister of assembly of Jammu and Kashmir will hold office during the pleasure of the lieutenant governor. Same at central also, prime minister and union council of minister hold office during the pleasure of the president. In the same way, in union territory of Jammu and Kashmir, the chief minister along with the other council of minister will hold office during the pleasure of the lieutenant governor. So in short, the ministers, council of minister as well as the chief minister, individually they are responsible towards the lieutenant governor, and collectively they are responsible towards the legislature assembly. Okay, same as it is there in Delhi. And apart from that, before a minister enter into the office or before a minister enter into the assembly, then the minister has to take oath and affirmation. And that oath and affirmation will be administered by the lieutenant governor, or it is the duty of the lieutenant governor to administrate oath and affirmation of chief minister as well as the other council of minister before entering into the office of ministry. Then apart from that, if the assembly of union territory of Jammu and Kashmir, it is not in session, then at that time lieutenant governor has a power to issue an ordinance. So whenever the assembly of UT of Jammu and Kashmir was not in session, then at that time lieutenant governor of Jammu and Kashmir has a power to issue an ordinance. This ordinance has same force as the law which is made by the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. But remember, the lieutenant governor can issue an ordinance only on those subjects on which the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir having a power to make a law. Then the lieutenant governor cannot issue an ordinance on those subjects on which the UT of Jammu and Kashmir does not have a power to make a law. So this is about the assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. Then High Court. So before bifurcation, there was a single High Court for the Jammu and Kashmir state. So after bifurcation also, there is a single high court. Single high court for two union territory. The high court which were present before the bifurcation, same high court is applicable to the both newly formed union territory, that is Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So in short, there is a common high court for Jammu and Kashmir as well as the Ladakh union territory. And apart from that, the judges which were present before the bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir in Jammu and Kashmir High Court, same judges will continue as the judges of High Court for Jammu and Kashmir as well as the Ladakh. And apart from that, there will be a salary distribution. So if judges will be there, then judges has to pay the, sorry, judges will get the salary. Then who will pay the salary? So judges salary. So judges salary will paid by both the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir as well as the Ladakh, according to or based upon the proportion of their population. So this is about the High Court. In short, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh is having common High Court. Okay. Then the judges earlier which were present before the bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir state, same judges can continue as the judge of High Court for both union territory of Jammu and Kashmir as well as the Ladakh. The next, the salary will be paid by both the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir as well as the Ladakh based upon the proportion of the population. So this is about the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019. Thank you. So please do like and share our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and don't forget to press bell icon for more updates. Thank you.